Ladies and germs, let's see what the fuck is going the fuck on. Okay, that'd be nice. I'm so sad. Sad. I'll tell you what I'm fucking done today. Shit. Doing a sec. We're doing a sec. Get your booty in the apartments, man. I need to do this. Is that? Yeah, there it is. There we go. New team at meet or so. There we go. Cool. So now we don't have to worry about that. It sucks at streaming, but hey. We'll have to just do our voicey shit. Because this always helps. Look at our phone. It's never gonna happen. No. Of course not. Okay. Let's also see if get this shit that we're gonna do. Nobody cares. We've pretty much given up on it though. It sucks. How are we doing for money? I didn't even check. I normally check. Dude, we're 38 grand. We're getting to a point, we might just say fuck it and just give up on being a cop. We might just give up on it. Like, we're not really getting anywhere, which is unfortunate, you know? Like, we're just not. Let's go to we're not gonna be able to get our like flying shit because there's never anybody available. I guess we just keep the money growing in our bank and just see what we do with it at a later date, you know? I think that's probably what we do. We do need to find something to do. Like, we need to find, a job or something. Like, the job that we want is probably never going to happen. Hey, you alright, man? I said, you alright? Oh, hang on one sec, dude. Hey, can you hear me now?
Alright, cool, good luck.
There we go. See you later, dude. Alright. Whatever, I don't hear any of that. That's what I am right now, as a grinder. I want to meet people and do stuff, but I really need it to occur in an organic way, and I'm just not really sure how I can do that. I don't fucking know. We're a sieve. We don't do crime. We try to obey all the traffic laws as much as we can. We don't always do. We just need to start getting some role playing. We really do, and I'm not sure Sexton's the way, to be fair. I'm not sure he is the fucking way. Because he's, as a character, he's kind of dull, he's kind of boring. He's got a very particular way of doing things. And unfortunately, those ways don't really end up getting him in a lot of shit. We'll just park over here and just... It's easier than trying to pull it in there and then park it out, It's a nice bicycle.
Thank you, sir. You're 7 to 9 speed.
Oh, green light. See you later, dude. There's only Stevens here. Jaywalking, that's about as criminal as we get, right? Hello, sir.
Yo, what's popping?
I don't know what's popping, but could I please have a murder meal, please?
I'm gonna go down. Of course you can. That's gonna be $101 plus tax today.
Perfect.
You
go to the vice parking machine and I'll
get your murder meal ready. Somebody serve me. I'm gonna go down.
What's going down?
I'm gonna go down. Serve me.
Where are you going down? Alrighty, order is ready. Thank you so much for choosing Burger Shot. You have a nice day and a pleasant tomorrow. I'll take the next customer.
Yeah, you took the bus.
Can you give me a combo meal with torpedo and coke, please, sir?
Are you fighting less a good tratter he does? How you doing, buddy?
Hey, what's going on?
I'm feeling very sad right now.
I saw you and I thought I'd better come and say hi, because I always say hi when I see you.
I know. I'm feeling very sad right now. I'm
Why?
Because I don't think...
Do you do rooster's rest? Do you eat that ramen and shit like that?
No. Well, I have... Okay, listen. I have in the past. There you go. But...
If you want it, it's there. I don't want it.
It's like... I don't know, man. My dream job. I'm just never going to get my dream job, you know? And I'm just... It makes me sad.
What is your dream job?
I want to be a police officer. But it's just... It's like damn near impossible, you know?
Why didn't you go to the Department of Corrections first or something? Because...
I already tried that, and they're like, listen, we're changing the way things are doing, and if you become a DOC officer, it's like basically impossible to become a cop, right? Like, they literally fucking said that. So I'm like, I'm kind of fucked. Like, for me to even like be considered, I need to get references, right? But the problem is like, nobody, like, I basically work, I do the news, man, so I'm like, it's easier for me to be by myself and try to sort of like...
I'll give you a reference, man. Hell yeah. By the way, how's your surfer dude voice?
Oh, bro. Oh, like, totally, bro. To be fair, I actually did.
You can become a lifeguard.
Maybe.
I'm a lifeguard in my spare time, you know, like, no bragging or anything. I'm a lifeguard.
That could work, you know, like...
If you ever see a yellow truck driving around with a lifeguard, it's probably me inside.
Okay.
Especially if it's Benny Brera.
I did do like a fake accent the other day. I was trying to stay in like undercover doing a bit of like investigative reporting. And it was like, right. I felt like it might have been like, it's very in poor taste. It was sort of like, let me see if I can do it like, I'm trying to remember what my voice was like.
Well, let me hear what you got.
Yeah. Like, dude, come on, man, you know, like, just, like, sort of lower and, you know, like, you know, just doing, like, this thing, you know, and...
All deeper.
The fucking police. Man, I'm damn bad, man, all the cops and police and shit, man, you know. It's just, I don't know, man, I didn't like it, like, unfortunately, like, I had to give myself a fake name, but unfortunately, the person that I was with...
What the fuck is wrong with your coworkers?
Hey, what's going on, what you mean?
I literally told them that I was low elf, right? I was almost passing out. And I had to, you know, eat a burger real quick so I couldn't pass out because I woke up at the apartment really hungry. You know, like really, really hungry.
Oh, maybe you need that ramen more than I do then, ma'am.
They threw a shoe at me after. Like, I was, like, that's mad research.
That's disgusting. That is, there's ramen there if you want some. No,
yeah,
throw a shoe.
They knew I was low elf. Like, they really wanted me to pass out. Like, what the fuck?
Really? I will go and have a word with them immediately.
Yeah, you should, dude. You should. Yeah, yeah. No.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, here's my...
Oh, yeah. That's, the number's probably going to be good, right?
I rip you a lot, but I don't actually have your number. See you later.
Yeah, see you later, dude. He does need to have a word with him. I don't know. I'm feeling sad. You know, like, I want to do flying lessons. That's a lot I want to do. Okay, let's eat this fucking ramen. It's fucking food. Food's good. I don't care about feeling lucky. Who gives a shit about feeling lucky? Oh, look, we can... I forgot, man. I was driving with the fucking... Fucking dash hand buses, man. Jesus Christ. But yeah, we got a couple of hours streaming McStreamer Cinnamon. We'll see what happens, you know. Like, you know, we'll just try to get a bit of. RP's gonna be different. Like, we really want to do like pilot lessons, and yeah, Dawn's in the fucking. Like, what's her fucking? Actually, what is the thing that she's got? Dawn. Okay. She does say flight and driving instructor. Do we call her out? Even though we're convinced that she's... If she's the only person that's available. Oh shit, we were muted for ages. You didn't fucking close my goddamn door, piece of crap. I don't know, we're kind of in a weird situation. Like, things are not going as I was kind of hoping that they would. Like, I knew that I wouldn't be able to get straight in. Like, we knew that we were going to have to put some work in and effort. But, like, now we're at a point. Like, now is the perfect point, really, because they're desperate for cops. We know that we can do it. We just can't get on their fucking radar, you know? So now, actually, I'll tell you what we're going to do, is we're going to do news thing, we're just going to do news thing, and next time we encounter a cop, we will talk to them. We'll be like, listen. I think we need to ask about ride-alongs, because we know that departments that we've worked in the past, ride-alongs, for the most part, have not been a thing. Like, they have been, like, on some servers, but for the majority of servers that I play on, ride-alongs most definitely are not a thing that are offered, because they're just too high risk for members of the general public. The closest thing you get to a ride-along was on RH, where we did the phase 2 cadets. So you already did like your academy session, which is just a couple of hours, and it's sort of get you familiarized, and then you basically ride along with an FTO and you just watch them work, which I was kind of bad at because I knew how to do everything. So we chased somebody down, and even though I was supposed to just stand there, I did the cuffing, I read the rights, and fucking Damien, like, I think he was a lieutenant, maybe he was a sergeant, I don't know. But Damien was like, he was just like bragging about like how I did this stuff that I'm really not supposed to. But I think that worked well for me. But for the most part, ride alongs are. I think that's what we do. Just gonna keep doing our thing. I think we got a nice. I've really been a little bit depressed the last couple of days over this. Because I want it. Because the thing is, I want it so bad that it hurts. Right? Like, for me, cop RP is the thing I'm most interested in. Civ RP holds less appeal to me than criminal. And obviously, criminal is like, criminal RP is what it is, fuck yeah. We should go back to the apartment and put our toy away, shouldn't we? That's what we'll do, we'll put our toy away. I think that's what we'll do, is we just can put our toy away and we'll see what's cracking. This is a dumb fucking intersection. You like literally have to turn across. It's my bottle of water, there it is. I need it. I need drink. Gert Lush. For now, what funky shit's happened to it? I'm always invisible in my apartment. It's a fucking weird situation. That's someone's daughter's car. We definitely signed in, right? Yeah, no, because we got 911 calls. Fucking news. There's like no crime going on, pretty much. So weird, dude. Lasai. Oh, get green now. Come on, get green. Yeah, green, baby. We're just driving around aimlessly. We're actually wasting so much fuel. We really are. But, I guess we can. Let's just check my... we have one dot. We need to go get some cash out of fuck. We'll probably end up getting, like, 200 out. 200 is probably a good number to have out, to be fair. That's always going to cover us for fuel. So let's turn up. Yeah, we've been sad, but you know what? Fuck it, we're doing good. I think this is the way we're going to go. We're just going to keep doing our thing. Which is kind of boring, to be fair. You know, but what we can do, you know? Withdraw 200. Perfect. Weird. Driver. Christmas Farm, let's go. Here we go. We're gonna enter, and this is where I want to go instead. Please don't be down here. You're not down there, that's good. Is there one up in the hills? There is one up in the hills. Which is what we could do. Oh, he just went the wrong way. It's like a dumbass. What was so dumb? Thank you. couldn't. That one, that's unfortunate. That one. So many B&Es. We'd really like to stop some of them. Or at least get murdered trying to stop some. almost out of the fucking road. God damn it. I deserve to get pulled over. I'm driving like a jackass. Doing any of those. Not going to that either. Well, we might head down that way. We could drive over it, actually. That could work. That could actually work at all. Oh, boom.
Hello, it's Kevin.
Hello, I'm wondering if you can help me. I'm interested in applying for and taking helicopter lessons and applying for a license as well. Is that something you okay. can assist me with?
Yeah. Do you have a criminal record at all?
I do not know.
Okay, so it's going to be $20,000 plus tax if you have no criminal record.
Okay.
I'm going to have to do just a background check as a formality. So if you want to text me your name as well as your state ID, I can go to City Hall in like 30 minutes.
I can tell you those now over the phone that you want me to text you regardless.
Oh yeah, text me because I'm in the middle of a class with somebody.
Oh okay, yeah, no problem. Yeah, I'll do that now. Okay, no, well I'll actually do it in a second when I pull over and it's safe to do so.
Okay, perfect. Are you going to be around for a while? Because we can probably do day one today.
I am probably going to be around for the next good couple of hours.
Okay, perfect. Yeah, so if you have the funds and the background check comes up clean, we can start today if you'd like.
Yeah, no problem. And do I need to apply for the license as well? Because that's an extra, $10,000 as well, right?
I believe it's $4,000 at the courthouse once you've completed the course and you pass the test.
Okay, no problem. I'll like I said, I'll pull over in a second. I'll get that text sent out to you ASAP. Okay. Okay. See you soon. Thank you. Bye.
You get a lot.
Sorry. What? That's fine. We know what we're doing. Okay. We know. We can compose a fucking text, motherfucker. Calls. So, can I send a? Oh, we can add him as a contact. Okay, so this is Kevin Instructor Heli. Boom. This is actually good. Submit. Now, we can send him a message. Oh, we're good. Boom! That's been sent out. We're actually... My fucking fan just turned. Do you know? I realized that my fan just turned off a minute ago. Wait, why did I come down here? This is bad, right? No, I do need to. Oh, this is so bad. This is such a bad idea. No, we're dipping out. We're literally dipping out. Dipping. We're dipping. literally dipping. Let's turn my phone back on.
Jesus Christ, I know what.
I know what I turned off. So dumb. That's fine. Oh. Whoa, I almost fell over there. Yeah, that's red light, who cares? It's better. So we're getting our first fucking lesson. Like. Oh, Beanie! There's this one too. Please don't be down here. I think these are the old ones. If you could clear them off, man, up here. That's much cooler. Even with this, listen, if it turns out to be less than like 34, which is, well, let's say 35, fuck it, then what the fuck? Then we know that that's actually gonna be good. If that's the case, that'll be like, we didn't really care, like, money means fuck all to us, but. It's even more reason for us to think that Dawn is incompetent. Hello?
Hello, I believe you called me.
Yeah, but I've actually spoken to, I believe it's Kevin, so I actually don't need to talk to you anymore. But alrighty, thank you for returning my call. Thank you.
No problem. Okay, bye.
We need to go get gas. Let's go get some gas. Especially if we need to drive all the way up to fucking goddamn Fort Zancudo. We can't do a U-turn now because that'd be illegal. So we'll head down to the fucking I know where we're going. get some gas. Drink your time, motherfucker. Actually, where is this? This shot's fired. Is that again an area we're not going to? Fuck! That was really good. It's actually really good. I like that. I've got all these fucking calls I can't attend to because they're all fucking goddamn in the south side. South side is popping off today, yo. Once we get a call, we'll go sign off because I'm not sure that we should be signed on if we're not actively able to go to like news calls. It seems. Like, in my experience, and the way that I feel like it works, is that, like, while we're on duty, we're getting an increased paycheck from if we were not doing anything wrong. And I feel like hitting those markers, that gives us a little bit of extra cash, a bit of bonus cash. Obviously make an extra 300 if you do tapes, which we try not to do, honestly, like, because, like, it just seems exploit, like, we'll only do the tapes if there's stuff that we can end up, you know, snipping from stream and putting on them, which is a thing that you can do, which is great. But yeah, we try not to make the tapes unless it's like a bank. Like, if it's a bank robbery, we'll make a tape. Like, price your range, you pussy. I don't think Bryce is about, to be fair. I think LGX is having fun with his potential cop character, Ryan. Wow, really? Fucking hell. Jesus Christ. Oh, here we go. That's funny. Hello?
Hey Gary, it's Kevin with Eric. How's it going?
How you going? Not too bad.
Okay, I'm doing pretty well. So I'm just having somebody run to City Hall for me to check out your background and stuff. But if that comes back clear, it's going to be $20,000 plus tax if you want to get it going.
Yeah, no, that's not a problem. And, you know, it definitely will come back because I've never been so much pulled over by the police, so.
Okay, gotcha. Hell yeah. All right, so I'm going to start filling out the paperwork, liability waivers, all that stuff on my end. I think the only thing I'm going to need you to do is text me your Discordia so that we have it on file and that we need to reach you when you're not in the city.
Yeah, no problem. I can do that now. Okay.
So probably within, say, 20, 30 minutes, maybe less than that, expect a call from me, whether or not we're good to go. Also, I have to make sure that the helicopter is actually available. Nobody's booked it just yet, but you never know.
That's true. You do never know. Okay.
All right, cool. Talk to you in a little bit.
No problem. Thanks. Bye.
Right, bye.
Okay. So here we go. So we go. Boom. Okay. I even fucked my writing. There we go. I hate writing that. That feels so OOC. It feels so wrong that you have to, like, do Discord, right? Via text. It feels way, way shittier than it fucking should be. Well, we'll go sign out of our job. We'll spend the next sort of 10-15 minutes. Getting all these bulls. Fucking Faggio. Y'all are fucks. What the fuck is going on, dude? Fucking hilarious. Oh, green light. Ah, that's me, not you, Burn. That's the turn now. Oh, fuck it, who cares?
I'm taking it.
Wait, we even pull over? We, like, even pull over when we're on the phone, dude. Like, ugh. We're living this fucking life. This isn't even fucking RP, dude. This is like fucking real life simulator, motherfucker. You know what I'm talking about? We'll go get our repair kit. So loud. What a cock. Let's message him and be like, yo. Yeah. literally texted me back. He's messaging me back. Here we go.
Yeah.
just driving around wasting fuel. Oh, fucking hell. Why does everyone drive like a cunt? Oh dude, he's gone, bro. Wait, what's this like, Tesla Lamb? We're gonna read it. God damn. Hello, Mr. Sexton.
Hey, Gary. So, everything looks good on our end. I filled out most of the paperwork. I sent you a liability waiver that I'm going to need you to sign via the contracts thing in your phone. I'm also going to bill you, and then if you're good to start today and maybe within 15, 30 minutes, we can start.
Okay, and where would that take place to?
Do you know where Fort Sancudo is?
That's the big place, that's the tunnel going underneath it, right?
It's like the military base. If you look at your GPS, it's going to be like halfway up the left-hand side of the continent. You also see like an airplane icon on the map. It's the AirX Flight School, that's where we'll meet.
Okay, no problem. I'll start heading up that direction once I've signed this documentation. Okay, boss.
Okay, cool. I'm also going to bill you via the application, and then once that goes through, I'll push all your paperwork, and by the time you get here, we should be good to start.
No problem. Okay, I'll do that in a sec. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much. See you soon.
Okay, so he said, let me double check my Discord, which not anything yet. I don't think you can do that right now, but no.
Hope you like the flavor, asshole.
What, do I have to guess it?
No, I said hope you like it.
Ooh, what's it? Oh, it's mint.
Love you.
That's beautiful. Sign of responsible hairs. Any person's firms. This is fine. Anyways, Yeah, no, that's fine. I don't need to do anything. Do we need... We do need to sign out. Just need to sign out. Signing out's important. Because otherwise it's fucked up. Like, we'd never go up there. Like, we know that's the easiest way. There, up there. But we wouldn't know that in character. Like, because, look, this is... So we know that this is the place. Oh, look. Got that water there. See, we still can't see. There's a bridge. So, like, that makes the sense, right? So, yeah, we're just... We're kidding. Hello?
Hey, Garrett, do you need me to ping you? I'm at the base.
Oh, no, I'm just rolling up now.
Okay, perfect.
It took me a little while to sort of work out how to get in, but I think. I'm here now, yeah.
Cool, see you soon.
Okay,
by no the helipad.
Okay, no problem. I'm not sure where helipads actually are, though. It's 15. Oh, the helipads are down the other side, right? Is that the right place? She's beautiful. Hello there, sir. How you doing?
Doing pretty well.
It's a nice outfit.
First and foremost, I'd like to congratulate you for taking the step to acquire your helicopter training license. Or helicopter license, sorry, not the training. First things first, can you just open your phone and look at your licenses and tell me if you have a temporary pilot license?
Yes, sir. Yes, I do have it does say expired.
Oh, yeah, pilot license?
Yes, so if I look at my license, it says driver's weapons, all my ones, and then when I click the pilot's license, it says it was issued today, and then it does say expired.
Okay, so if you go to the info app, do you see it there? Does that have a green check mark?
It's just populated.
Perfect. So it usually takes 5 to 10 minutes for the ATC to pick up that you actually have a license, so they don't zap your helicopter out of the sky.
That'd be unfortunate.
So you know, if you're caught using this license without a RX light instructor, you're essentially going to be banned for the rest of your life from actually obtaining a license.
Okay. No, I fully understand, Jeff.
Alright, it will be on your app and in your possession until the tsunami rolls in, and then once the tsunami rolls in, it'll fall off.
Okay.
Alright, so if you step over here and look into the helicopter, and you look at that dashboard over there, what do you see? What kind of controls do you see? Is it a keyboard and a mouse-looking control, or is it a controller?
It looks like sort of special sort of driving gloves. You know, not necessarily like a full keyboard on my phone, but it does sort of look more like controllery.
Okay, more like controller. Okay, cool.
It doesn't play fly, but I can't actually fly.
Before we start, I'm gonna go over probably the most important rules, the ones that will get you to lose your license the quickest. If you are in the air, actually, if you want to take out a notepad or your phone to jot down some notes, this will be very helpful because you are gonna be quizzing this before you actually pass. On to get your license.
Okay.
Alright, so there are some places that you are not allowed to land a helicopter.
Anywhere from the
top. Those places are going to be the hospital, MRPD, generally any police real estate. You're not allowed to land on the battleship down south. You know, if you've ever seen it, it's like an aircraft carrier, has bombs, missiles, the whole nine. And prison. You're also not allowed to land there and or fly over their airspace. Understood?
So basically it's any sort of government property.
Yeah, that's one way to look at it. When you are tested though, you're gonna be asked specifically to identify these places. Government property is generally the places that you want to avoid. There are some carve outs that we're working with the police department and the government to have. At least for my business, outside of doing Eric's stuff, I have a taxi service that uses helicopters, so we've got some exceptions for things like City Hall, which is technically government property, but we're able to land on the lawn in front. That's more of a Sky Express kind of thing.
Providing it would be safe to do so, obviously.
Yeah, so anything that I tell you, I'm just assuming that you're exercising some level of common sense and also the highest level of safety, both for yourself, your passengers, and the people below you. Okay, now to move on, we're going to go over some terms as well as. Actually, have you ever had experience flying aircrafts with the current driving gloves?
No. I've been up previously in a helicopter, but I've never actually flown myself.
Okay, gotcha. Alright, so I'm gonna go over some terms, and then we're gonna try and map it out, so you have an idea of how it corresponds to the controls in the,
like, the thing is he's gonna tell me stuff that I already know, which is fine.
If we get in there and we find out that some things, don't match, we can correct it. So first is gonna be pitch. If you ever use the keyboard
sticks.
Module in there, then that's going to be
8.5.
For
yeah.
You, with your particular driving setup, it should be pitch and roll should be the leftmost joystick looking thing over there. See that?
Oh yeah, I see it. That's it. Just there.
Yeah, so that's how you're going to pitch and roll. Pitching is basically what you're going to do to move forward. So you get in there and you know, knock the module forward. You're gonna tilt the aircraft, and the aircraft is gonna go forward.
And this one's gonna lose altitude.
Rolling, it's essentially leaning left and right. You're gonna do it with that same module. So it should make perfect sense when you're actually in there. You know, forward, back, forward, down, left, right, etc. I think every day I'm just going to quiz you on the terms and we'll go through as quickly as possible. Next time, today we'll take our time and just kind of talk through it. Next term that you're going to want to be familiar with is yaw, and yaw is essentially spinning in place.
Yeah, that's the buffers.
With the module that you have set up, it's going to be the They're gonna look like triggers. It's gonna be the topmost trigger. So y'all left and right. Does that make sense?
Yes, sir.
No, and essentially you're gonna be set spinning in place, so if you're at an altitude, you're just gonna do something just like this. We'll gradually lose altitude if you do that eventually, but kind of depends on momentum, direction of head and all that. Alright, the next term is going to be flare, and flare is essentially to pitch the nose of the aircraft upwards. So imagine if you're moving in a straight line at 100 miles an hour, you pitch the nose up, it's going to bring the plane to, or the helicopter in this case, to somewhat of a, not a stall, but you're going to start to lose. The reason you do that is because you're trying to either turn sharply or you're preparing to land. You want to do it as efficiently as possible. Any questions?
No, I think I got it on down. Let's lose the aircraft down wicked.
Okay, cool, cool. Couple more terms. Thrust is essentially just moving forward. We've already gone over where to fly, where not to fly. One that I left out is the power plant. You do not ever fly over a power plant. You do not land there. That is basically instantly forfeiting your license back to the state. Additionally, if you are not in possession of the license, the air traffic control of the city picks up on it with the GPS and whatnot in your phone. And if you're flying or attempting to operate a vehicle without a license, that vehicle will malfunction. You will likely crash and die, and or if you do survive, you'll get charged with terrorism and then you'll never be able to fly
okay.
or get a license. We're going to go over the refuel points next. There are essentially three main ones, which one is here at Fort Sancudo. Then there's one up by the airfield over in Sandy Shores. We're going to take a trip to those probably tomorrow. And then the last one is going to be down at Vespucci. Do you know where Higgins Dock is?
I think so. That's roughly where that recycling salvage place is, right? It's in that vague vicinity there. The freeway loops above it, right? Not above the heliport, but above the recycling center. Yeah.
Yeah, it's, I don't know how long you've been in town, but there used to be, the fishing guy used to be down there. It's where you pull out the boats. There'd be, like, a little blue house icon on your GPS. It'll say Higgins Dock. Some people also refer to it as Vespucci Helipad. It's the closest helipad to Vespucci. Then the last refuel point that you're going to need to or want to know about is going to be at LSIA. There's a hangar in the airport that lets you refuel. Additionally, here at Fort Sancudo, the hangar directly in front of me is where you repair the aircrafts. There's a Benny's in there. He'll come out and help you, and he also lets you refuel there. So if this helipad is ever occupied and needs to refuel, you just go into the hangar, refuel. This is technically all AirX property, so want to have some sort of clearance or I don't want to say pre-approval, because if you need to stop for gas, you need to stop for gas, but you don't want to linger too long, you know?
Oh yeah, definitely.
And then yeah, those are the refuel points. Any questions?
No, I think I've got everything.
Yeah, LSI also has a Benny's down there. It's in one of the hangars. Eventually, you'll probably just go down there, just kind of explore. It's where you get the rentals out. This particular model aircraft is $5,000 a day, very expensive. I actually rented one today, and I guess the guy sold me one with a cloaking device because
I did see you tweet out about that.
Yep. It's very, very unfortunate, and I'm livid, but what can you do? So I'm assuming with your, assuming you know how all the other things on the controller module over here function.
I mean, so obviously I've never flown before. However, I am deep into my sim game, and I've flown multiple times on armor. Now, obviously this is not a video game. This is real life, obviously.
Right.
But you know, I understand that there's that, the handle down to the side that helps you sort of gain altitude and lose altitude. Obviously we've gone over the stick, like, you know, the pitching the aircraft in different locations. Obviously, all of the buttons on the control panel, they'll be, you know, sort of something I'll have to learn. But I think I've got the theoretical application of flying a helicopter down, Whether or not I can pull that off in a practical sense is obviously completely another matter, you know?
Gotcha. All right, let me just run through the whole list. Start from the right. Top right trigger is going to be aircraft, y'all right. Bottom right is going to be helicopter ascent. Bottom left is going to be helicopter descent. And then top left is going to be y'all left. We've already gone over y'all. I will quiz you on this probably tomorrow, just as a practice quiz, and then on the third and final day, when you do your final exam, we'll do one more roll through this to make sure that everything is sorted. The leftmost stick inside the cockpit is going to be how you control pitch and roll. You don't have to worry about landing gear here, but you also interface with the landing gear by pressing that stick down. Yeah, that's pretty much it. None of these have access to weapons. You really shouldn't be using your phone while flying. You take off, you're going to want to 3-1-1 that you are taking off. The 3-1-1 should generally be formatted in a way that starts with your call sign. So my call sign is Sky Express 001. And then I'll say, like, today we're doing this instruction. I'm going to be like taking off from the Fort C for day one AirX. Heli lesson, and then that'll be it. Or I can expand on it and be like, oh, and please. I can expand it and be like, heli lesson, what's your name? But I'm probably not going to do that. And then tomorrow you'll essentially do that, and you'll say something like, AirX student, taking off from Fort C for day two flight lessons, number and yellow pages. And you put your number in the yellow pages with the call sign associated, so if they ever need to contact you, they have a way to do so.
Okay.
Alright, that's all the info that I think you need at this point. You're taking notes, so just review those notes after we're done here, and then before the next class, there's a simulation that you can download at home. You can kind of fly around, experiment, test some of the things that we talked about. Simulation, I believe, is called Grand Theft Auto 5. And I don't know how exactly to get a helicopter in the simulation, but I hear you're able to get one. Okay, cool. So I'm going to get in the helicopter now. I'm going to throw in one that we're going to be taking off, and then we're going to fly around the airbase. I'm going to essentially show you what I'd like you to do, and then I'm going to swap seats with you after I land back here and refuel, and then you're going to do exactly, or something similar to what I've done, and then that'll be it for the day.
Okay, no problem.
Let's get
back. Hello?
Put one down over there.
That's not where I wanted to sit. There we go.
Express 001 taking off from 4C with a student from Eric Helicon D1 number no pages. Alright, so to turn on this vehicle is the same way you turn on any vehicle today. So however you're set up to do that should basically be the same on this console over here.
Okay.
And so first I'm gonna just hover. When you're actually in here, I'm gonna want you to just hover for a little bit, make sure your license is in order. Sometimes it can take 10-15 to actually make effect. And then if the aircraft is stable and we're going to ascend a little bit, we're going to try and have you fly up and down this track over here.
The runway.
This airstrip. Just see you move. Basically,
place to climb forward, and then when you get to the end, you can turn around and come back, and probably land on the helipad, or you can fly around for a little bit there, along the course of this.
I think he's going to think I'm an idiot, but I think we want to definitely be a little bit wobbly. Then we can improve tomorrow or whenever we get in next. I'm really slow deliberately. That's kind of my, well, maybe not like an Air One pilot, but I definitely want to join the police at some point. It's just, it seems very difficult, you know.
Go ahead and make a left. You can fly around the base a little bit, and then just trying to stay in the line. You could also gain a little altitude. Yeah, the police have a different set of, training stuff that they need to do for helicopter flying, but getting comfortable with it here, it's probably a good step if you eventually want to be certified to fly that that chopper.
Right now, I think I just sell my grandmother to actually just get in the force and then worry about the rest of the stuff later, you know?
Okay. That, I think, is maybe the hardest part, to be honest, from what I hear. But yeah, so, pretty stable. We can go and land on the helipad, we'll throw some gas in, and then tomorrow will be the day where we fly the most, and then the third day will be the most.
Not quite as majestic as you, but...
Practice. You can readjust if you want to try and land directly in the edge.
No, I think that's... I think I pushed my luck far enough today. I think that's it.
So we're going to be done here at Lemmy 3 and 1. The correct thing to do in this situation, and let them know that we're out of the sky. Just if anything is happening in the area, they know what's on us.
Okay, cool.
Like, what are you typically around in the city?
See, that's the thing, is, like, normally, I try to wake up sort of very early in the morning. This is really about as late as I'm normally able to, like, be available. But again, it's kind of difficult. Sometimes just, you know, it's a comfy bed in my apartment. Sometimes it's just difficult to roll out of it, you know?
Yeah, I got you. I just sent you a text, day one complete.
Yeah,
so
I got it.
If you roll into town tomorrow, you know, 2 days from now, 2 weeks from now, we know where we left off.
Brilliant, that's fantastic.
And if you took notes, it's essentially going to be the same thing. I'm going to roll in, we're going to just quiz on all the terms, where to land, where not to land, where to refuel, and then we're going to have probably the longest flight suggestion that you're going to have with the AirX. And then on the third day, we'll do the actual quiz, because it's essentially going to be the same thing as we did the second day. You're going to go, you're going to fly around by yourself for 10 to 15 minutes, you're going to refuel, maybe check out a few different locations of interest, and then yeah, you'll come back here, assuming you do the 301 correctly when you take off, and the 301 correctly when you land, you will have passed, and you'll need to speak to a judge to confirm that you have completed the course, and he will issue you a permanent license. And that permanent license will be good as long as you stay in line with the laws.
Yes. Basically, don't be a jackass like everyone else on the roads is.
Yeah, essentially, yeah. That's pretty much it. You know, exercise common sense. When you're taking off and landing, try and do it from a helipad. If a helipad's not available, open areas, flat areas, places that aren't going to be disruptive or destructive is kind of the mindset I try and approach the kind of thing from. There are a few places that are, like, we're trying to carve out with the police department for my aircraft taxi business. So that's, like, a completely different course, I think. But if you're ever interested in that, you can ask me once your license is taken care of.
Yeah. Well, I'm not signed at the moment, but currently I do the whole newsman thing, you know? Like, I like it. It gets me around the city a lot.
Yeah.
And I feel like I know, I'm pretty sure there's already a news helicopter that's about, but
oh yeah, Ron has one with the news. You work for him, right?
I don't know. I'm a sort of an independent contractor.
I see. Yeah, I know they have a helicopter. I think it's a 2-man job. Essentially, you need somebody to pilot and you need somebody to actually use the camera.
Yeah. Yeah, probably. But that's definitely has interest. Just, you know, maybe doing sort of like, you know, once I learn the city a little bit better, you know, maybe doing sort of tours, that, you know, that definitely has potential. And then I guess it's, you know, while I'm waiting for, you know, to get in the police force, I guess we can always then start saving up money and maybe looking at fixed wing.
Oh yeah, I think fixed wing is another 20-25k.
Yeah.
Record and all that. It might be 25 to 30. I'm not sure.
Yeah.
I'd have to check the list.
Well, like the thing is like, you know, I don't want to sound, I might sound like a pretentious cunt, but money really doesn't really mean anything to me, you know. Like granted, I have a van. It's pretty shitty, but it's mine, you know. Like, it gets me from point A to point B. You know, I'm not really a car dude. You know, I'm not one of these people who's gonna, you know, want to buy like a Lamborghini or some bollocks, because I already worried I sound like a pretentious cunt. I don't want to drive like a pretentious cunt as well, you know.
I think if you're able to wake up during this tsunami, at the very start, we can, most days, we can get your lessons taken care of.
Yeah.
I can also try and be around before this wave, but I think, I'm not sure what the schedule looks like in the morning for the flood school. It seems like it's very much a tale of two cities, where a different set of things happens before this wave, and then a whole set of different things happen after.
Yeah, I think you're... Oh, my God, you're tired.
Hell is Kevin.
We didn't really have a chance to do the sort of RP that we wanted to. You know, we definitely... Like, we could have, like, swung around and, like, attacked with our dick out, you know? But that really wasn't to be... like, we're done here now, which is a good time for me to stop. Hopefully we can get here tomorrow about this time, and then we're good.
Right, yeah, what were you saying?
I honestly don't remember. Sometimes I do have the memory retention of a goldfish. Most of the time I'm good, but if, like, my train of thought gets interrupted, I'm absolutely useless.
That's pretty much it. Day one's completed. When you're in the city, just text me if I'm not around. Or if you text me outside of this wave, I'm probably not around. Worst case, if too much time goes by where you're not able to be around these hours, we'll probably try and set something up for you to either sync up with me earlier or whatever.
It's been really difficult for me to sort of, like, find... Because I've been about quite a lot recently. Like, this week is really good for me as far as, like, availability when I can roll out of bed. But it's just been difficult. It's like, I've constantly checking the yellow pages, and there's normally nobody, like, even, like, advertising as an instructor.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know if you literally have very few of them or what the deal is, but...
Well, you know what it is? A lot of the people who work here also work for the PD, so, their main thing is, definitely to do the whole law enforcement stuff. So the amount of people who are around all the time for instruction can be limited, especially if you're not around during these hours.
No, that's understandable.
Hold on, let me just go and check and see if my helicopter managed to unstealth itself. If not, I may or may not need to bump a ride from you back to the city.
That's fine. Do you want me to drive you over to the hangar, at least?
Yeah, let's do that. Never know what these things, man. Sometimes a cloaking device turns on and it's gone.
Dude, that happened to my van. That happened to my van a few days ago. It was like, I pulled it out. I just pulled it out and it wasn't there. And then, you know, quick nap and it was fine. And then, well, I think yesterday I actually had a psychotic episode, I'm pretty sure. I was driving around looking for stuff. I looked at my GPS, and then the next thing you know, when I come out of my GPS, I'm stood in the middle of my road and my van's disappeared. It was why the fuck is my oil light on? I drive like a fucking old lady, for fuck's sakes. It's my own light on, man. I feel bad for him, dude. It's like $1,000. I love his run. I love the fucking run, dude. The run is amazing.
Fuck it, it's gone.
So, where do you want to drop off to?
The city? Apartments? Where are you planning on heading?
I'm probably going to get apartments because I actually do need to. Well, probably Hayes, actually, now, so, or someone to repair my van. Because I don't know.
You can go to Hayes and then just run down. Oh, I might have a friend there.
No?
Might be on the right.
Just don't tell anyone I'm speeding, reindeer. It's 15 mile an hour. Just don't tell anyone.
Oh, I think those signs were more from when the base was still active. They didn't want to, you know, people flying around. But now I think the normal speed limit should be okay, 35. That's my guess. I'm not a lawyer nor a law enforcement officer.
Yeah, well, I was a law enforcement officer, and the response to that is ignorance is not an excuse to the law, sir, or ma'am.
That sounds like something a law enforcement officer would say. And they'd be correct.
It's true.
I'm just gonna meditate for a quick minute.
That's fine.
Okay, what was your CVT one more time?
12225.
Alright, I when you get a chance, look in your contracts and just sign the liability waiver.
Yeah, so I got that, but I wasn't sure how I signed it.
Oh yeah, sorry, I needed to share with you and then sign it. That was my bad. Should so now when you go to contracts, you'll see an option to sign when you click on the top right three dots.
Okay.
As you're looking at it.
Okay, that's fine.
There should be like a signature thing, and then there should be like a button you can kind of press.
I hate driving so much. Okay, I've signed it. So now do I need to share it back or?
Nope, you're all set.
Brilliant.
If you want the a longer form version of the document, I can send it to you. It's essentially the same thing, it's just Google kind of thing.
No, I think I'm okay for Tira that's gonna send me off to sleep, thank you very much.
Your flying is pretty good, so I don't foresee any sort of accidents. Just on that first day, like I said, there's a simulation you can get if you just want to like practice. Let you more or less know the format of what you're going to be tested on. Kind of do some test prep.
Yeah, I think I'll probably end up doing that because who knows when the fuck I'll be the next time I get in the city, you know?
Yeah, fair enough.
It is, but it's one of the worst junctions in this fucking place.
Oh yeah, 100%. You said Hayes, right?
I meant whichever one's in the city.
Oh yeah, Hayes.
Is that Hayes? I don't remember.
Yeah, I think.
I do apologize about my driving, but I do take great pride in never having been pulled over.
Oh yeah, I used to be the same way as you, to be honest. And then I got my first ticket, and now I never stop running.
Like, I'm the worst newsman in the history of newsmen, because I'm never going to get the scoop, because I drive like an old lady.
Yeah, you'd be surprised. People do shit in broad daylight if, they don't even realize somebody's
gonna watch them. That's true. I was debating about taxi, but again, I drive too slowly for that. People ain't got time in this place for a slow ass taxi driver, you know?
Yeah,
fair
enough. On the right side.
Thank you.
steel rod boat.
Oh, God.
You.
Oh, thank you, Mr.
Bill.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, guys.
Can I get a name real quick?
Yeah, it's Mr. Sexton, Mr. Gary Sexton. Yeah, it's weird. It's like, I parked up, it was fine, and I got back in it, and then the oil light just, like, came on.
You said you parked it.
I literally parked it.
When did you park it? Like, just recently?
I parked it, yeah, it was, I basically drove it up to Fort Zancudo for a helicopter lesson. I literally just parked it up, and then, yeah, this is probably, like, maybe an hour ago. And then I got back in it again, like, half an hour ago or so, and it was just...
Oh, my God. I'm gonna be, honest
with
you.
It's fucked.
It's pretty fucked up.
Oh, bollocks.
It's pretty fucked up. Here, let me do the calculations real quick. It's gonna be $1,426.
That's fine.
That's okay?
Okay. Well, I mean, it's not, but, you know, it's not exactly got a fucking choice,
okay,
you know.
Okay, paying that, I guess. Like, you have that in your account.
Yeah, no, I've got it in my account.
Okay.
I may have to cry a little bit later when I get back to my apartment, you know.
Yeah, I'm sorry, man.
That's
our
fine.
Prices are cheaper, though, so this
no,
is
I like know.
$1,800 normally.
No, and that's fine, but, you know, like... No, I don't want you to think less of me just because I might have to go home and cry like a young, you know, baby.
Where did you get this repaired?
I've had some body work done it, just like at Benny's, but I think the last proper...
Just one or two.
I think the last place time I got this repaired was here, actually, I think.
Alright, as soon as you accept that, I will get started.
There you go.
I'm sorry.
It's fine.
I'm gonna do the best I can.
Well, that's all that any of us can do. I do love the fact that you say that you'll do your best. It's like what, you're just gonna do your worst? No, of course you can do your best, it's fine. It just seems an unnecessary thing to say, you know?
I'm gonna do my best to emotionally support you, that's what I
mean. You see, that's what I need. I need all of the emotional support right now.
That's what you guys do on the property, my shit gets stolen.
So angry.
Why this dude?
I don't know about that, it wasn't that good when it was new, but yeah, sure.
Oh. Okay, it will be...
It'd be as equally shit as when I got it. Brilliant.
Exactly.
Excellent, that's what I'm looking for. Oh, you're really getting in there. Okay, look, you're really getting in there.
Yeah, I told you I'm doing my best.
Yeah, now you, yeah, see?
I do what I can to help you guys. Especially in a situation like that. Just be sure to park this right away, okay?
Oh, definitely.
Do
me
a favor and do that.
I absolutely will.
Alright, perfect.
That might have actually been the issue before. Very angry man.
You are all set to go.
Okay, wonderful.
I would try to avoid the situation going on outside as best as you can.
Okay, there's I'll be gonna see there's some food there for you.
What's this?
It's just some fries. I'm like I said, I'm going to bed in a second. I literally don't need it, so.
You're too kind. Oh my god.
I know.
Don't cry yourself to sleep.
Oh, I definitely will.
No, don't. Do not tell me.
Fine, I totally won't cry. I have to wait though. I don't feel comfortable driving it right now. We'll go get our fucking paycheck later. Next time we're in the city, we'll get it. For fuck's sakes. because 5 minutes is 3 hours, which isn't very long, really. Easy. We've been streaming for like an hour. Exactly. Wow, we're not invisible? That is the pokey. It's not true. 17. Boom! Let's go find something to rate there.